step on my tongue. I can't take you. You're so bitter, better get up and run. Warning! Ah, for an hour. When revenge comes calling. Warning! Ah, for an hour. You won't.
Hello, my pack, my tribe. Welcome to Ranting Night, or as I'm actually going to change the name to it, to Truth Telling. This is a show where I talk about whatever is on my mind, essentially. I'm talking about things that bother me, things that piss me off. Things that I think you can relate to, and I try and do it in kind of a comical way. Or rather, I should say, an angry way, actually, because pretty much everybody I know tells me that when I'm angry and or drunk, I'm kind of funny. So, and I want to entertain, so here we go. Tonight's topic is social media. Now, I will say that for the most part, social media is a good thing, I think. In large part, I was reunited isn't even the right term, really. Found, I guess, by my biological father's real family, who I met for the first time in 2015, largely because of social media. So I do have kind of a soft spot for it. But having said that, can we please, for the love of God, stop sending me these fucking stupid notifications telling me about your latest fucking update on your wall that has absolutely nothing to do with anything? Can we please, for the love of God, please fucking do this random person that I hardly ever even know and probably have never even met face to face in real life, number 62? Can we please fucking do that? Can we please stop with the asinine, meaningless bullshit? That's not why social media is there. Nobody gives a shit about the funny little costumes you put on your poor little kitten, okay? Nobody gives a shit about it. That's not what it's for. Believe it or not, it really isn't. It is not for that. If that's what you're about, post videos on YouTube like every fucking sensible person on the planet. And I have no idea why the fuck my dogs are barking. Anyways, what social media was actually intended for was either to reunite or keep in touch with those people, either really close to you or just on the periphery of your life. Family, friends, even business associates. That is what it was intended for. We are literally flooding the internet with asinine, meaningless bullshit on a day-to-day basis. I have, and I'm not shitting you, I just checked and went through and turned the Facebook clock, if you will, back to fucking zero 2 days ago. As of today, I have 84 notifications, and 99% of it is incredibly stupid, meaningless, oh, I put a fucking tutu on my cat today bullshit. It's enough. And I know I'm picking on Facebook a little bit here, but I will be honest. Twitter is fucking million and goddamn 99 times fucking worse. Oh my fucking god. The tweets that come out, half of them I don't even understand what the fuck they're talking about. Most of these people are fucking inventing hashtags that don't even fucking exist. Has no bearing on life at all. Now, there have been some awesome ones. I will say that, being a Native American, or rather of Native American descent myself, I had a lot of appreciation for the whole I don't know more thing. If you don't know what that is, look it up. Trust me, look it up. You're going to want to know about it. No matter which side of the fence you're on, you're going to want to know about it. So look up I don't know more. It started in Canada, it turned into a worldwide fucking movement, and then fucking blew up in the White House, evidently, when Pine Ridge Rez tried to get permission to buy back land that was already fucking theirs to begin with. But I'm not going to get into that whole fucking thing. And there were hashtag I don't know more posts all over the fucking place, and it was beautiful. Millions and millions of them during that whole time, and it was great. But I've seen some that just, they make no fucking sense. They have nothing to do with anything at all whatsoever. And it's all fucking pointless. And here's the other thing that fucking pisses me off about social media. Primarily with this one, it would be on YouTube. Okay? So let's say that a random person A takes or makes a video on YouTube. And it could be something they didn't even make themselves. Like a lot of people post movies and TV episodes and the like on YouTube. And I'm all for that, by the way. And this day and age, I think quote unquote piracy laws concerning primarily video content are bullshit, because everything's online now, literally everything. So I really appreciate it when like somebody, for example, posts the latest episode of my favorite TV show, because I don't have like direct TV or cable TV or anything of that nature in my room. All I have is internet, and that's all I feel a need for. Netflix, by the way, is wonderful too, but they don't always have everything. So as a consumer, watcher, whatever you want to call it, I really appreciate when people do that. What pisses me off is the fucking haters. You know, people that... probably the fucking worst one, and I'm not going to say the poster's name, not out of any great respect for them, but simply because I don't want to be fucking sued, but somebody fucking actually said this ignorant bullshit. It was actually an episode of a show, and I don't remember exactly what the show was. I think it was like a Forensic Files type deal, where it was like real life crime, real serious matter, and basically this guy, and I don't remember exactly what the fucking comment was, but I fucking went off on him. He was basically blaming the victim of this heinous fucking sexual assault and murder for what happened to her. Now, normally, I would have just ignored the douchebag. Or at least attempted to. However, what set me off, and the reason I went off on this fucking guy, was one of the people that posted before he made that post was a family member of the fucking victim. And not only was it a family member, it was this person's 13-year-old cousin. And this guy's saying ignorant bullshit. And it wasn't exactly word for word this, but it was something to the effect of, well, the fucking cunt got what was coming to her, and the police should be ashamed of themselves, blah, blah, blah. Basically being a fucking internet psycho about the whole thing. And so I went off on the guy, and it's been too long, I don't remember exactly what I said, but it was something to the effect of, how fucking dare you say some ignorant ass shit with her fucking 13-year-old fucking family member paying attention to these posts, you ignorant cunt. I tell you what, why don't you come to fucking Akron, Ohio, and we'll see if we can recreate the crime, only you'll be the victim. Yes, I was that pissed off. Eventually, calmer heads prevailed, of course, but, in the heat of the fucking moment, it is what it is. But, and I've seen some negative posts. I get it. Everybody's got a fucking opinion. But just because you have an opinion does not give you the right to fucking voice it. Yes, free speech. I get it. It is guaranteed right. Just like the right to bear arms is a guaranteed right. And I'm not going to get into that whole fucking thing either. But here's the truth of the matter, okay? There is a difference between having the right to do something and the moral code to fucking know better. Just because you have an opinion about what every fucking buddy does, just because you're all rainbows and sunshine, doesn't mean that you get to fucking voice your fucked up bullshit fucking opinion on what random person A posted on fucking YouTube. Yes, you have the freedom to do so, but should you? Really? I mean, it's the same rule as something should just not be fucking said. I mean, would you really walk into a funeral home during a funeral and say some random ignorant bullshit about the person that's being buried? Who does that? Nobody. So the same rule should fucking apply, even though it's online. That's not a safety net, people. That's not permission to say whatever random bullshit is flying through your brain. It is not an excuse not to have a fucking filter. Especially since there are other people that are gonna see that shit. There have been times when I had opinions on shit, and I didn't voice my opinion. Because I knew it would be upsetting to some people. They would not be in the frame of mind to fucking hear it. And those people probably don't listen to my fucking show anyways, but that's not the point. Enough is a fucking enough. Now, I'm not trying to say that, you know, you should be censored, yada, yada, yada. That's not what I'm talking about. No, nobody has the right to fucking tell you what you can and cannot say. And that's not what I'm trying to get across. What I'm saying is that there is a fucking problem because people, for whatever reason, on the fucking internet seem to have forgotten that there are other people involved and have removed that filter that tells them, well, maybe this isn't the best thing to say. That's not to take away from your freedom for saying it, but let's face it, some shit, if you fucking say it, you're just showing that you're a fucking douchebag. You know, and I'm probably guilty of it too at some point. But if you were to look in all my social media posts over the years, I'm sure that you would see that the majority of them, I've tried to be, you know, kind of the voice of reason, I guess. And I say kind of because I have a tendency to go off when people piss me off. Just saying. Look, the whole fucking point of tonight's show is just because it's the internet and you're typing on a keyboard and the people can't see you face to face. And even if they could, like if you were on Skype or something, that doesn't mean they necessarily know where you live. And there's no repercussions and yada, yada, yada. Well, I got news for you. There are repercussions, whether you realize it or not, because everybody's brought up, or I shouldn't say everybody, most people are brought up with, you know, some kind of moral compass, and when you yourself are throwing out all of your own consequences for your bullshit, you're breaking that moral compass. And you may not think that that's a big deal. You may not think that's anything for you to worry about because you're safe, you're behind that keyboard. But I promise you, sooner or later, that shit is going to translate into real life. You're going to end up slipping up and saying the wrong thing to the wrong fucking person. It's already happening. It is already fucking happening. I'm sure if you were to look into it, there's been probably fucking several situations where somebody has been hurt, maimed, or killed because of some shit they said because their filter was not turned on. Because they were still in internet mode in their brain and didn't realize that what they were saying wasn't on a computer screen at that point in time. I can guarantee you that's happened more than once. But, you know, maybe there'd be no physical repercussions at all. But that doesn't mean that there are no repercussions. Because you're actually damaging your own moral compass when you do that shit. It's like that old rule, think before you speak. Or better yet, how about the golden rule? Treat others as you would wish to be treated. It's not saying, oh, you can't have the freedom to speak your mind. You treat people with fucking respect. Because honestly, I don't give a shit. I don't fucking care what anybody has to say about me. Because I'm telling you, good hearted, moral fucking people love me because I tell the truth. People that have no filter, that say random fucking ignorant ass fucking stupid hurtful bullshit on fucking line don't fucking matter to me anyways, because all you are at that point is just some fucking douchebag, probably some 12, 13, 14 year old fucking punk kid that doesn't know any fucking better. Which is gonna open up a whole other fucking topic about parenthood and today's society and how there are no consequences anymore, and I'm not gonna get into all that. My point is just because there's nothing stopping you from saying whatever random bullshit is popping in your head doesn't mean that you should say it. Remember, there are other people there, is what I'm getting to. Just because it's on a computer instead of in a crowded bar doesn't mean that there's not people there. People are going to see what you say. I hope that makes sense. Anyways. So yeah, it's hard for me to go on social media anymore, to be honest about it. Not because I don't care about people. Well, let's be honest, I kind of don't. I work a lot of you that have listened to me before know this, but I work for an organization called One of a Kind Pet Rescue. I work in kennel. I get to be around dogs all day. And I love that because I understand animals more than I will ever understand people. That's just the truth. Doesn't mean I don't care about people. I do. I just don't care about most people. Because most people, in my honest opinion, are just fucking idiots. To be honest with you, they are. And I'm not calling, you know, you specifically, my listeners, idiots. I would never do that. Obviously, you must have some brains for listening to my show. just kidding, but sort of not. Anyways, what I'm getting at is that the vast majority that I have encountered are not people that I would really care about. Anyways, really. I mean, I would care about them in the way that you care about every person, but I wouldn't care about them in the way that I would be interested in having any kind of personal relationship with them. I don't have to be best friends with somebody to go into a fiery building and save them, in other words. Or, I don't have to care about them as a friend or whatever, to keep a dog from biting them, for example. You know, I care about people in the ways that kind of in a general way, I guess you could say. I care about society, or in nowadays seemingly the lack thereof. But people just from the jump, before I've even spoken to them, I guess you could say I'm cautiously optimistic. You know, I don't think most people are worth very much. In a social kind of way. I don't. Now, having said that, that's from my experience, from my viewpoint. So, my viewpoint really, at the end of the day, really only matters to me. And I know that. Just like from your viewpoint, the people I care about may not be people you care about. And people you care about may not be people I care about. In that way. Because everybody's got their own viewpoint. But the thing is I would never say some random ignorant shit over something you post. In fact, if it annoys me at all, like 99.9% of like Facebook notifications, I just ignore them. But if you're talking some random fucking shit, making other people feel bad or look down on themselves, or essentially being a fucking cyber bully or a bully or whatever, yeah, I'm gonna fucking say something and you're not gonna like it. I'm just being honest. Because, once again, just because it's behind a screen and you're not face to face with the person doesn't mean that there's not real feelings out there. And when you bruise somebody's feelings, that can get dangerous. Just to be real about it, because you never know who you're talking to. I actually had, I'm going to tell you this story. I actually had a friendship. It was an online friendship, not a relationship, so no funny comments. An actual relationship with this guy. We were friends for a couple years online. We had never met face to face. I was on one side of the country, he was on the other. Had never met face to face. And then he messaged me one day and said, "Hey, I'm going to be in your neck of the woods. You want to meet up?" I'm like, "Sure, why not?" And we did. We ended up meeting up. And it was a great experience. Nothing bad happened. We got along really well. We hung out at a sports bar, watched a game on big screen. It was in San Diego at the time, so it was, you know, Chargers versus whoever they lost to. You know, and it wasn't Hooters, but it was actually Junior Seau's restaurant, which was called Seau's before he, no, I'm not getting into that, but, and I don't think it's there anymore, but, you know, it was a great, like, restaurant, sports bar. It was basically like Hooters, sort of. But, you know, great place. We were flirting with the waitresses, and they were flirting a little bit back, and, you know, it was a great time. And we hung out a bit after that, and did a few other things. Went to Dave & Buster's, played a bunch of video games. I went hung out at Pool Hall, played some games of pool, and it was shit like that. And then his trip was over. It was just a couple days, and he had to go back home. I'm like, "Cool, man, it was great to meet you face-to-face finally, you know, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera." And, so he flew home, and I hadn't heard from him in, like, a couple weeks. And I was getting kind of worried because I knew he was flying home. I hadn't heard anything about a plane crash, but that really didn't mean that there wasn't one. So one day I'm like, "Look, I don't know if you're getting my messages or what, but if you could please message me and just let me know that you made it home, okay? I could stop worrying about it, and we could go about our merry ways." Well, somebody text, or not text me, but messaged me back, saying, "This isn't, you know, Joe, this is so-and-so, I'm his cousin, he hasn't answered you because he's in prison." I'm like, "Prison? For what?" It turns out this dude was part of the mob. Now, that doesn't make him a bad person, and I don't personally have anything against that necessarily. I'm not for it either, but I'm not against it. But I never knew that about the guy, is my point. I never knew that. 2 years of talking to this guy, I never knew that about him. I wouldn't really have cared, to be honest with you, because I've known some people before, and they were just like regular people to me. I mean, they never did anything in front of me, or you know, what have you, but they just seemed like regular people. I don't know, take that for what it's worth, but in any case, my point is I never knew that about the guy. Now, had I been online insulting that guy, talking down to that guy, making him feel like shit, how hard do you think it would have been for him to find me and arrest my case? You don't know who the fuck you're talking to. when you're online saying random bullshit like that. You don't. Chances are, there's going to be no repercussions at all. So you're probably fucking right about that. But there are a lot of crazy motherfuckers out there that just don't give a shit, that are just sitting there waiting for somebody to push that fucking button that will make it their life's mission to fucking track you down and fuck your world. Because there are those fucking people. And there are more and more and more of them nowadays. Because I got news for you. Road rage is real. And what I'm talking about ain't that fucking far removed from that shit. Point is don't fucking poke the bear. Because you don't know. You just don't know. Yes, 9 times out of 10, it might be safe. But you never fucking know. And that never fucking knowing, is that really worth the risk, number one? And number two, not to mention the fact that you shouldn't be a fucking douchebag anyways. You shouldn't be making those random, dumb, idiotic, fucking bullshit, fucking posts on, like, Facebook or whatever, making people, or rather trying to make people fucking feel bad about themselves. There is such a thing as fucking morality. Internet does not fucking change that. And to quote Eddie Murphy, who was actually quoted somebody else at the time, have a Coke and a smile and shut the fuck up. Because some things just don't fucking need to be said. Yes, granted, random person A's fucking little fucking kitten in a tutu video on YouTube was probably annoying as shit. But hey, you know what? You're the dumbass that fucking watched the thing in the first place. So who's really to blame there? See what I'm saying? There's no reason to make random person A feel fucking horrible about themselves just because you didn't appreciate the video. If you don't appreciate it, don't fucking like the thing and watch something else. Because the reality is it has zero bearing on your fucking life. But you could fuck theirs. You could reach that. I actually heard this fucking story too. It wasn't YouTube though. It was what is that, Vimeo or whatever the fuck it is. It's like YouTube, but different. Somebody had posted a video on there, and there was a negative comment in their feed. And the person had seen that and had committed suicide. Because somebody had posted a negative comment. My point is just because you don't see that there are consequences doesn't mean that there isn't any. Your actions, your words have real life consequences. And I know that's a foreign concept with how parents are fucking raising their kids nowadays, but trust me, there are consequences. And I know it may not seem that way growing up in your parents' house, sucking on mama's tit, punching your little keys, saying whatever random shit flows through your head to you know, the people out there that are posting videos or content or whatever. Doesn't even matter. And I'm sure you get a big kick out of making yourself feel so good by putting other people fucking down. But trust me, that's what the kids that got themselves shot because they were fucking bullies way back in the 90s in Colorado, that's what they thought too. Columbine, those two kids that did that shit, they were bullied. That's why they did it. And just because you're safe behind a keyboard, or so you think, doesn't mean that there's not real consequences to that shit. Point being, think before you speak, think before you type, don't be a douchebag. And thus endeth the lesson, ladies and gentlemen. And I thank you all for tuning in. I don't know when I'll be on again. I'm not a regularly scheduled show anymore. I'm trying to figure all that shit out. Which is hard because I'm now working two jobs. But I will get back to you on it. Until then, my pack, my tribe, peace out.